Unless...
Go on, Mr. Butler.
Well, the only thing I can think of is envy. Jim was honorably discharged after Vietnam. He didn't like to leave the army, but there was no way he'd ever see active service again. When I was talking about my plans, well, you know how it is. It just started eating him up.
Okay, now you've got the idea. Let's try one more scene, eh? Remember, you're ordinary people, either yourselves or someone you know. So just relax and let your real feelings come through. Okay?
Oh, oh, look at that dear little dog that's come into our garden. It looks as though it's in need of a real home.
Oh, what's going on here? How did this ugly mongrel get inside?
Oh, please, Miss Bennet, she's on her last legs. Can't we keep her till she gets better?
I'll see that you're shot for breaking in here.
Ow, that hurts!
Showing my real feelings.
This is a prison, not a dog's home.
You reckon?
If you hadn't started all that arguing, Miss Bennet wouldn't have wanted to get rid of her.
Why don't you pick on someone else for a change?
Just for that, you're going to get 2 weeks in the pound, Gilmore. For being selfish and such a pain in the backside!
Little baby bitch!
The governor warned you about there being trouble. I'm sure she's going to be very pleased to hear about this. You see that Mr. Pierce has shown out? I told you your little lot would bring an end to this nonsense.
You little bitch!
Talking about?
I got into a fight in the class. It wasn't me that started it, I swear. It was Doreen and Lizzie. They were the ones who started it all. But you know Bea, she's blaming it all onto me. Well, don't just lie there. What am I going to do?
Apologize to her.
What?
Look, there's nothing I can do, love.
What's the matter with you? You gone soft or something? You never let anyone walk all over you before. Or me. You've always looked after me.
Well, I will.
I know what it is. You've gone off me, haven't you? Yeah, I've seen it coming. You don't care about me anymore.
Don't say that, honey. I mean, you know that's not true. It's just that I can't look after you much anymore, that's all.
Yeah, sure. And I bet you'll be real sorry when Bea belts the living daylights out of me, too.
Listen, will you listen to me, damn it? I'm trying to tell you something. I'm trying to tell you that I can't look after you anymore because I'm sick, damn it. I know that you think I'm just out of condition and tired and all that, but it's my heart, honey.
It couldn't be. You're as strong as an ox. You're pulling my leg.
Well, I know all the symptoms. Long time ago, Sharon, I watched my mother die. She had a heart attack. She's only 48. I'm nearly that age, love.
Oh, I wasn't expecting you back so soon.
I couldn't bear to listen to anymore. All those lies. The whole thing was revolting.
I'm sorry.
Vera, you didn't.
Well, I thought about it, and if no one did want the dog, well, I couldn't let it be put to sleep, Meg. And she seemed to like me.
And in passing sentence, I take into account the fact that you have no other record for violence. However, I cannot discount the arresting police officer's statement or the testimony of the two reliable witnesses, regardless of the defence's efforts to prove otherwise. Geoffrey Arthur Butler, I order you to be placed on a bond of $500 to be of good behaviour for 6 months. Should you break this bond, you'll be returned to this court for further sentencing. Should you abide by this bond, the conviction will no longer be recorded. This court is adjourned.
Congratulations.
You really had to do it, didn't you?
I couldn't lie, if that's what you mean.
Well, I've got to stay in this lousy country for another 6 months because of you. I've lost that recruiting job and now I've got to try to scrounge a living.
You're lucky you didn't end up in jail.
You've ruined me.
You did it to yourself.
Yeah, well, I hope you rot, you bastard.
Excuse me.
Get out of my way.
You and I have a lot in common.
Like what?
Being stood on by Jim Fletcher. Look, I'm not a rich man, but I have enough. You need work. Maybe we could work something out.
Maybe we could.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down, but the sun and rain are prisoners too. Around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the storm. The roses here are prisoners too, when morning comes around.